Today in Matters of Fact, a hearing of nearly 6 hours in the Senate tackled practically all issues against the franchise of ABS-CBN, the Philippines' largest media network, which the government's chief lawyer wants to shut down. How will this impact deliberations at the House of Representatives, where at least 12 ABS-CBN franchise renewal bills are pending? Joining us today from our Rockwell studio, PBA Portales Representative Jericho Nograles. He's a member of the Committee on Legislative Franchises. He's also pushing for the renewal of ABS-CBN's franchise. Good morning, Congressman, and thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Christian. Good morning to everyone.
Okay. Yesterday, it was a long hearing at the Senate. Of course, many members of the lower house had issues regarding the Senate conducting that particular committee hearing. But based on what you saw yesterday, do you think there was a shift in momentum that could somehow convince more of your colleagues in the House to finally support this franchise renewal bill?
Well, just to clarify things, the initial apprehension of members of the House of Representatives in the Senate in hearing yesterday was based on the constitutional question on whether they can hear it at all. And obviously, after 2 hours of debate in the Senate, they were able to come to understanding that they'll investigate in aid of upcoming legislation. Mm. So it's not necessarily the franchise issue yet. So they wanted to hear the complaint. As far as the House of Representatives is concerned, there's a huge shift already in the leadership direction as far as the 12 or more franchise bills pending in the House of Representatives. And that shift is mainly that the House of Representatives is now open to receive position papers from any party. So that means anyone from the government, anyone from the private sector, anyone from the labor sector, any sector whatsoever, the committee on legislative franchises of the House of Representatives is now open to receive the position papers, whether for or against the renewal of the franchises of ABS-CBN.
Now, what prompted the shift? Was it the Senate committee's investigation?
I wouldn't think that the investigation in the Senate prompted the shift, because I prefer to believe that the House of Representatives is a separate constitutional body from the Senate. And that being the case, we try not to be influenced by external factors, but only with what is before the House of Representatives. So at this point in time, the Committee on Legislative Franchises is happy to move forward with the issue. And what prompted it? I suppose it's just time. If you put things in perspective, the three franchises of ABS-CBN has been pending even in the previous Congress, in the 17th Congress, from 2016 to 2019. And these three franchises were refiled in 2019, last year. And this year, 2020, we're now hearing or about to hear the franchises of ABS-CBN.
Yeah, because I was also looking at the timing, because this announcement was made yesterday by the Committee on Legislative Franchises that they would start receiving position papers for or against ABS-CBN's franchise renewal bid. But of course, yesterday also was the Senate Committee's hearing, so there was a perspective regarding the timing.
Well, that's a perspective that is not well-founded, if I may say. I would like to really credit the leadership of the House of Representatives to make good in their promise that they will eventually hear the franchises of ABS-CBN. But bigger issue right now is, will the franchise be renewed in time? Because we have three franchises, and the three franchises will expire in various dates within the 18th Congress. So the ABS-CBN franchise itself, the Sky Cable franchise, and the multimedia telephony franchise. So these three franchises have different expiry dates, and the first two expire is ABS-CBN itself. And that is the big question. Will we be able to tackle it in time? And based on the rules of Congress, it won't be, there won't be any sufficient time to pass the franchise in case that we vote to pass a franchise within the allotted expiry period. So that puts ABS-CBN in a gray area beginning March 31. Will they be able to broadcast continually? Will the NTC stop them? Will someone apply for the frequencies? We don't know at this point in time. It's all speculation. But at least on the side of the House of Representatives, the leadership really is trying to convince members of Congress that we will hear. And we are welcoming, at least 91 members of Congress are welcoming the development. And with the pronouncement yesterday that we are now accepting the position papers, that's a move forward that everyone welcomes.
Okay, just to clarify, because yesterday, according to Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara, the expiration of the ABS-CBN Corporation's franchise would actually be on May 4, 2020, not the end of March, next month.
Well, that is subject to debate. The date is very clear that it's up to March 30. But if that's the interpretation of the Justice Secretary, it's independent of the interpretation of the House. Now, the interpretation of the House is still pending because we have not met. So we are hoping that we could meet sooner than later. But indications show that probably it might be heard on May or August. So that's all entirely dependent on the leadership.
So just to be clear, you don't have enough time anymore to deliberate and let's say decide on the franchise renewal bills before March 30.
Well, I think if we start hearing it, we'll start hearing tomorrow. How many hearings will it take to pass the franchise? And not to mention that there is an upcoming congressional break. So the break begins on March 15, and we will adjourn until May of this year. So that's a pretty long break in Congress. So there's a big question whether it can be passed in the House and then transmitted to the Senate. Will there be a bicameral conference committee and then the signature of the president? That's the whole process. And based on the usual timeline of the House of Representatives and the Senate, it's highly unlikely. So unless the president will deem the bill as urgent, then chances are we won't be able to renew it before March 31st.
Okay. Now, you mentioned the gray area. That was also discussed yesterday in the Senate committee hearing. And there was a position given by the Justice Department, which was also somehow afterward accepted by the National Telecommunications Commission. The fact that, according to the Secretary of Justice, Congress can issue a concurrent resolution that would instruct the NTC to issue a provisional authority allowing ABS-CBN on other similarly situated broadcast networks or stations to operate while their franchise renewal bills are still pending. Do you think this would also be accepted at the lower house?
That's technically incorrect because concurrent resolutions passed by both houses are only for matters that affect both houses. Joint resolution is a more proper term.
Yeah, precisely.
Because there are three kinds of resolutions. So joint resolutions are different from concurrent resolutions. So those are technical matters.
Yeah.
But joint resolutions between the Senate and the Congress can direct or guide the National Telecommunications Commission, but it does not necessarily have the force of law.
Why is that?
And the franchise is a law.
Yeah, yeah. Good thing that you clarified that, because yesterday I was also curious why the term used by the Justice Department was concurrent resolution, when I think it should have been joint resolution to cover both chambers of Congress. But in case a joint resolution is actually proposed, do you think this would also be supported at the lower house?
That's yet to be seen. We have to look at how the members of Congress would vote on the matters presented before them. And that's the thing about Congress. You can't really predict the vote of Congress until the debates have begun in Congress. So without any debates, we can't even hear the complaint of the president or any other offended party by the business of ABS-CBN. And that's the job of Congress. The job of Congress is basically to debate on matters, to debate on issues, and to decide whether or not we will renew a franchise or stop a franchise. Our job is to debate. And without any scheduling, then we can't debate on anything. And we can't also predict the votes until the evidence or the presentations are put before us. But as for us members of Congress, we're excited and anxious to hear the merits and demerits of the renewal of the franchise of ABS-CBN. We generally wish it was sooner than later, but again, the scheduling is really up to the leadership.
Pardon for this question, Congressman Nograles, but if you say that members of Congress were excited to hear the issues, why didn't the leadership schedule this much sooner?
Well, I would leave that to the leadership, so I can't speak for the leadership. But you know, but as far as 91 of my colleagues are concerned, they have signed a resolution petitioning the immediate hearing of the franchises of ABS-CBN. So if you want to count numbers, and Congress is a numbers game, there are at least 91 members of Congress who want to hear the franchises of ABS-CBN.
But after listening to yesterday's Senate committee hearing, do you think more members of the lower house are now more open to, let's say, supporting the fresh 25-year franchise for ABS-CBN?
Well, I would suppose that the signals were very clear that people are excited, not just the senators, but the general public are excited to hear the debates in the House of Representatives. And what I can assure everyone is that the leadership of the House of Representatives is ready to hear it within the year, that's for sure.
Now, as far as you're concerned, how do you address this gray area that will happen after the franchise of ABS-CBN Corporation expires at the end of March?
There's no other choice for Congress but to hear it. That's the only way, and there's no other way to address the gray area. On the part of the executive, specifically the National Telecommunications Commission, that would be a separate matter. And I cannot predict how the NTC will treat an expired franchise. Although there are two precedents, that being GMA7 operating without a franchise for about a month, and Radio Veritas that operated without a franchise for 2 years. The closest precedent in the case of ABS-CBN would be Radio Veritas, whose franchise expired in April of 2017, and their franchise lapsed into law, therefore renewed on April 2019. The NTC didn't do anything. They did not put them off the air. They did not give them an order to go off the air, and they continued operations. Those 2 years, I'm pretty sure, was very difficult for Radio Veritas, and even the month was very difficult for GMA7. But and we can only predict what will happen with ABS-CBN.
But do you think that should also apply in the case of ABS-CBN? Being allowed to operate while the franchise bills are still being deliberated on.
Well, there are two opinions on the matter, and both are on the extremes. One says they are not able to operate legally, and the other would say that, since they have a pending bill in Congress, they can operate. And that being the case, you know, anything can happen from one end to the other in the gray areas. That's why I said it's a gray area, and we can't really predict what will happen. So a direct question there, will ABS-CBN be put off the air? It's possible. Will ABS-CBN continue to operate? It's also possible. What will happen? We don't know yet. It's a case-to-case basis.
Now, you mentioned yesterday that the committee had begun accepting position papers for or against the franchise renewal of ABS-CBN. But still, don't you think this is quite slow? That it took you so many months just to start accepting position papers?
Well, Congress sets its own pace, and that is true for every single Congress since Malolos, so since 1907. If it's slow, then it's slow. Then that's the characteristic of the current Congress, and that's the characteristic of the Congress now. But we have to take things carefully. And at the same time, in taking into consideration all the sensitivities.
But what do you think really is stopping the House of Representatives from actually deliberating on and once and for all deciding on this bid to renew the franchise of ABS-CBN?
As with anything in Congress, everything is a leadership call.
Can you elaborate on that?
Well, it is what it is. I'm sorry, but it's really just a leadership call. We all look to the leadership and say, hey, are we ready to tackle this or are we still gathering information? And the last time that I asked that, I think that was at least with reference to last year, the explanation was we're still gathering the information, we're still gathering all the complaints, we're still gathering all the positives. And right now, they've opened it to the public. So that for me, as a person who, or as a member of Congress who's been waiting for the deliberations, it's a very welcome pronouncement on the part of the leadership that they're already accepting the position papers of everyone.
Do you think this is also a case of the House leadership trying to give something to the public? Because in the words of your colleague, Congressman Lito Atienza, the House of Representatives was embarrassed by the fact that it was the Senate committee that decided to conduct a hearing because the House was not moving.
I don't think so. Again, I'd like to believe that the House of Representatives is composed of 308 independent-minded individuals who would like to tackle the issue as it comes to the House of Representatives. Like I said, it's been all these three franchises have been referred to the committee, have gone through the first reading, and we've been waiting for the proper time to deliberate on it. And the fact that there's movement, that's welcome.
Now, if you say that the House is composed of 308 independent-minded individuals, why do you have to rely so much on the leadership call?
Well, that's the rules of the House. You know, you have to elect a speaker, you have to elect the chairman, you have to elect the majority leader, the minority leader, and we're still a democratic House, and the rule of the majority will really be heard. And so far, if you put the numbers together, you have 91 who signed a petition. Versus 308, you know, 91 of 308. So it's still not yet the majority who's really pushing it. So even with the 91 that want to hear it immediately, that crossed party lines. So that's independence.
But it might also be the case that other lawmakers or members of the House are waiting for signals coming from the House leadership, and that the House leadership might be waiting for signals from Malacañang itself. What do you think?
No, again, I'd like to believe that we're independent. So if you say that that the speaker is waiting for signals in Malacañang, it's as if that the speaker and the president don't speak. That's part of the whole democratic process, that they'll be able to talk to each other. But again, the House has its own rules that is separate and distinct from the Senate rules, and the House will hear it when it's time. And in this case, the House leadership has said that it's coming, the time is coming.
Okay. Now, we know that, of course, the franchise bill emanates at the lower house, and that was also made clear yesterday in the Senate hearing that they won't come up with a committee report on that. They just heard the issues, okay? So they're not necessarily encroaching on the responsibility of the House to actually start things off when it comes to the franchise renewal. But there was also an apology coming from ABS-CBN's head yesterday in the Senate hearing. How do you think this would affect somehow the mindset at the House and, of course, the issues raised by the president himself against the franchise of ABS-CBN?
Well, I would think that it would set some air, clear some air, rather, because the big question prior to the apology of the president of ABS-CBN was whether or not ABS-CBN admits that there is any fault. And the apology that was offered by the president of ABS-CBN was very clear that they did not intend to offend the president, and that they meant no harm, and that they offered their apology, and that's and that for me is big of ABS-CBN, and that would be taken into account when the deliberations of the House of Representatives will begin later this year.
Don't you think the complaint itself is quite petty when it comes to, let's say, complaining about certain ads, local ads, which were not aired, when in fact, as it came out in the Senate hearing yesterday, other politicians, other candidates during the previous elections also had issues when it came to certain ads which were not aired. But here you had the president complaining about certain local ads which were not aired by ABS-CBN, which happened because of the process involving the entire thing. So people are saying, isn't that quite petty, especially coming from the president?
Well, that's the whole democratic process. Whether it is considered petty or it is considered big, it will be heard. So like I mentioned previously, when the hearing comes, at that point in time, we already have everything from the big complaints to the pettiest of complaints, and each complaint will be weighed. The same way we are going to weigh all the positive defenses for ABS-CBN, that too will be weighed, and then Congress or will make a decision whether ABS-CBN merits a renewal of its franchise.
Yeah, of course, just to clarify the perspective that the complaint coming from the president himself was quite petty, because in the sense that why would you go for, let's say, the closure or make calls for the closure of the of a TV network just because of that particular complaint. And yesterday it was clarified by the NTC also that when it came to certain violations or shortcomings by the network, a fine could be imposed to the amount of 200 pesos. Of course, that was quite ridiculous in terms of amount. But the point was, I think this was also made clear by Senator Ralph Recto, you don't go for capital punishment to address certain issues that came out during the course of the franchise exercise.
Well, we also have to take into consideration that no less than Senator Bongo mentioned that the president is not vindictive. So the president has a complaint. It's no secret. It's part of the campaign. It's part of his presidency that he complained about ABS-CBN. But at the same time, Senator Bongo made it very clear he's not vindictive. So we cannot say that the Congress, whether it's the Senate or the House of Representatives, will take that complaint heavily or lightly. It depends on the individual that is a congressman or a senator. And it's Senator Ralph Recto thinks it's petty. Some senators think that it's not. They're entitled to that. I mean, they're elected for how they think and how they vote. And the same way in the House of Representatives, some members would take that as petty and some members would take that as something very heavy. And that's the whole democratic process.
Okay, just
so
to be clear.
So it's not whether or not that the president's complaint is petty. It's whether or not that the complaint of the president will sway how members would vote.
Okay, just to be clear, Senator Recto didn't say that that was petty, but of course he mentioned you don't go for a capital punishment, let's say the death penalty, when you talk about certain supposed violations by the TV network. Now, my final question, Congressman Nograles, is this. We were talking about signals earlier. The fact that Senator Bongo mentioned that the president is not vindictive, how do you think this would affect, let's say, the judgment or perspectives of your colleagues there in the House when it comes to deciding on the franchise renewal bills?
For sure, the two announcements were welcomed by a lot of members of the House of Representatives. Announcement number one would be the president will respect the independence of Congress. And announcement number two is that the president is not vindictive. which means Congress will not be a rubber stamp. And members of Congress are given the independence to weigh the pluses and the minuses on the renewal of the ABS-CBN franchises.
Okay, Congressman Jericho Nograles, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Christian. We'll be right back.